Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to my channel, and as always, thanks for watching. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever gone on vacation or just out and about, you took your camera with you, and you took some awesome pictures? You took the time to, you know, get those settings just right. You put that picture on your computer, and once you're done with the edit, it looks awesome. So, you know, you put it on your phone, you upload it to Instagram, and it just doesn't look that great. Well, in this video, I'm gonna share with you my export settings for Instagram photos to get those sharp, awesome looking photos on your feed. Coming up. Before I dive into the content in this video and I show you my export settings, if you haven't already subscribed to my channel and you want to learn more about what it takes to make YouTube videos, gear reviews that'll help you along the way, tips and tricks and all that good stuff when it comes to photography and filmmaking, make sure you go down there, hit the like button for this video and subscribe and hit that bell to be notified for my next video. I really appreciate it. All right, so you've gone out and you've taken some amazing pictures and now you're done with the edit in Lightroom and you want to export that photo for Instagram. So what do you need to do? My recommendation is the very first thing you need to do is right click on that picture and create a virtual copy. Why do you want to do this? Well, for me, sometimes I go back to these photos for prints or for future use and I don't want to have to go and uncrop it. So I like to have the original edit and then one that's cropped for Instagram. So make a virtual copy. Once you're done with that, you're gonna wanna crop the photo into a 4:5 aspect ratio. The reason you wanna do this is because that's the largest photo that Instagram allows you to post, and it takes up the most real estate on the feed when someone's scrolling. So we're gonna go up to crop, and we're gonna click on that, and then we're gonna click 4:5. Now, when you're in the vertical setting, it's automatically gonna crop to that 4:5 vertical. But what if you have a horizontal landscape you've taken? You've taken a really beautiful landscape, but you don't wanna post the horizontal picture. You wanna take up the most real estate on Instagram. Well, again, you're gonna click 4:5, but it's gonna default to that horizontal 4:5. So to get it to the vertical, just click X, and then you can adjust that to center it just the way you want it. But another recommendation I have for you is if you're taking landscape photos, the best way is to do it in that horizontal setting. But if you know ahead of time you're gonna go ahead and post that picture on Instagram, what I recommend is knowing that, shoot vertical just for a few shots so you can have that perfect vertical shot for Instagram. Now that you're done with the edit and you've cropped it for Instagram, let's go ahead and export that photo. So right click and hit export. Now you need to choose the destination of where you want that photo to end up. I just go ahead and choose desktop for now, for this example. Now we need to choose a custom name. Go ahead and hit custom name, and then if you're exporting numerous photos for Instagram, go ahead and hit edit, and then I like to go _IG. That way, if I'm exporting multiple photos for Instagram, when they export, they all say IG at the end, so I know what they're for. So go ahead and hit done. Let's scroll down now and take a look at the file settings for our export. You wanna make sure you choose JPEG. And then now there's some difference in opinion here. I like to keep the quality at 100%. Some people say lower it to around 75, 76%. But you know, you're just gonna have to mess around to see what works best for you. I always leave it at 100%, but let me know what you do down in the comment section below. Now for color space, you wanna make sure you choose sRGB. That's the default color settings for all monitors, whether it's a phone or a computer, so make sure you're choosing sRGB. Next, we wanna look at image sizing. This is the most important part of our export for our Instagram image. We wanna choose short edge, and then we wanna make sure that short edge is 180 pixels. Okay guys, Future Jared here, editing the video, and I noticed I kept saying 180 pixels. I don't know why I kept saying that. It's supposed to be 1080 pixels. So every time I say 180 pixels, just know I meant 1080 pixels. So when you're resizing the short edge, it needs to be 1080, or if it's horizontal, it needs to be the long edge at 1080. Just whatever the width is, needs to be 1080 pixels, not 180. Stupid, I don't know why I kept saying that. Anyway, back to the video. The reason for this is right on Instagram's website, it tells us it allows us to upload photos from anywhere from 320 to 180 pixels in width. So 180 pixels in width is the max width we can upload to Instagram. So because we're doing that vertical, we want that short edge, the width of that vertical to be 180 pixels. Now on the flip side, if you are doing a horizontal picture, we want to make sure the long edge, because it's a horizontal picture, the width is the long edge, we want to make sure that long edge is 180 pixels. Again, this is so important that you do this when you're exporting images for Instagram, because again, right on their website, they tell us that if we upload images larger than 180 pixels in width, they will downsize it, and we want to limit Instagram messing with our image. After that, we can mess around with the pixels per inch. I keep mine at 100 pixels per inch. Again, this is personal preference. Let me know down in the comments what you do, but there's really no need to go higher than 100 pixels per inch since we're not printing. Now after that, we go down to image sharpening. Some people don't sharpen. I do. I sharpen for screen and I leave it at high. Again, this is personal preference, and let me know down in the comments what you do. All right, now that we're done with all our export settings, we can go ahead and export that image onto our computer, but now we need to get that image from our computer to our phones. So how do we do that? It's super easy. If you're on a Mac, you can go ahead and airdrop it to your phone. It's gonna airdrop the full resolution export you just did onto your phone. Whatever you do, do not text it to yourself, do not email it to yourself, because it's going to compress that image. And then when you go to upload that image onto Instagram, you're going to be uploading a compressed image, and we do not want to do that. So airdrop it to your phone if you're on a Mac. But what if you're not on a Mac? What if you're on a PC? Well, the best way to do this, I recommend uploading it to Dropbox and then downloading it from Dropbox onto your phone, because it will download the full resolution image so you can upload it to Instagram. All right, guys, so those are my export settings in Lightroom for Instagram photos. I know there's a ton of different opinions and different ways to do this. Let me know down in the comment section how you export your photos for Instagram. But if you got some value out of this video, do me a favor, hit that thumbs up, and don't forget, please subscribe and hit that bell to be notified so you don't miss any of the awesome videos I have scheduled coming up. All right, I'll see you then.